Yes, family, our wonderful sister here is so excited because she is back at the Ike's Cafe. One of her new favorite places. A reminder of being in Jamaica, connecting to our roots and culture. And she has been so excited. She's so sad that we're all leaving tomorrow.
Jamaicans are Ashanti people.
Yes, my queen. Yes, my sister. Yes. Another one of my Jamaican sisters, my sister Mimi here, enjoying it. Say hello to the family. Yes, this feel like your home, your roots and culture.
And we have to wear masks to enter, so I have my mask.
All right, cool. Enjoy yourself, family, and enjoy your mask.
Where's my boy?
Yes, man, your boy is probably back there chilling, sleeping, relaxing. He's enjoying it. Are you gonna go get him? You can get him. Yes, family, and this is our beautiful red bus. We're winding down, family. This is Sunday, January 3rd, and tomorrow is the last day, January 4th, and we return, or the people are returning, return January 5th. So that's December 24th, departure from the U.S. and return to America, or North America, January 5th. So 10 full days in Africa, and what you're looking at, family, is us showing you the highlight of the development of Ike's Cafe and cultural village. This is incredible. And that's the development right there where we're gonna literally, you know, see a hotel being built. We're gonna catch up with our group as we give you just another nice view. No, we've been here many times, but every time we come here, we still got to give you a view because there's new people. The place is being developed, and we got to keep updating you with the energy, the strong energy. So now we're going to go to the station here. As we talked about yesterday, sometimes it's one of those things, where you'll see the mask sign, no mask, no entry. And in this case, it's one of those things where you just gotta get yourself ready.
She's 13.
And then for people like myself, the mask is gonna have to be passed out because it's 90 degrees out here. So we're gonna keep it real, keep it flowing. Yes, my brother, it was so nice, we have to do it twice. So let's see, we're all right here. Cobla, Mr. Cobla. Some of us going the wrong direction. Right, so family, up there is another restaurant section and the restroom. And we're gonna take it down here again. And this part has been... Right, develop a little bit more. I remember when all of this right here used to be an open section. Listen, everybody is excited to be back here. Let me just show you a small view of up here. Don't want to let anybody feel like we're just recording them. So let me show you where our group is. Let's give you a different view. This entire section right here is new. And this used to be an open section. What are we looking at? And yes, family. This is a big compound / restaurant, their social gathering place, nice and laid out. And I love it, man. Lots of fresh water wash station. And this is less busy as it was yesterday, Saturday. So many different events going on. It's a group right here chilling, and they are ready for fine dining. Yes, family, it was so nice. We're doing it twice. Yes, and right there, getting it in.
Yes.
It was a bunch of them. It was real nice.
And it feels like a nice little private section.
The all white band.
It wasn't keep with the art.
There you go, brother. Yes, you love the Palace Museum. It was awesome.
Love the Palace Museum.
You felt like royalty?
We are royalty. We don't feel like it, brother. We are royalty.
There you go, man. That's what I'm talking about. We are royalty.
Sir. All thanks to you. We appreciate it.
Yes. It's a great experience.
The greatest shopping was there.
The best prices.
Oh, you love it, right?
That was yeah.
I went back for seconds of shopping.
That's what's up, man.
That's right.
Hey. Right here at iCafe, talking about our experience in the Asante Palace Museum, Mansha Palace.
All day spending money with black people, man.
Yeah, that's not for the whole journey of a lifetime.
That's right. Black restaurants.
So any of the haters out there that want to talk junk, that's what we do with the money that we collect.
That's right.
Since, you know, we spend and distribute it amongst black-owned operation for the entirety of the tour. Huh? So if you're talking about black power, that's black power. If you're talking about black economics, that's black economics.
It doesn't have a big,
you know?
Big and we show people land and everything, you know? We show them all of the
okay.
You know? So family, that's how we're doing it, man. We lead by example because, you know, there's a lot of phonies out there, a lot of people talking and making videos in their hotel room and out there, you know what I mean? You know, and building up their views. I mean, I don't give a damn about no views and no subscription,
right.
You know?
That's right.
When you're out there, you know, keeping it real and doing work, you ain't worried about being no star, no celebrity, you know?
I guess everybody's at church.
You know, so family, that's how we do it. Raw and live on Revolutionary Cam. You got locked out? That's the COVID exit right there. So back at Ike's Cafe, family. It was so nice, we had to do it twice. We have a whole other section out here. This is the first section behind these doors. Is where we stayed at the first time we came a few years ago. So it's child's proof. Get it all wrapped up. And yes, family, we're the first set of people here because we're ready to just have an early day, enjoy this beautiful meal early. And then literally, family, literally, yeah, head out and do our restaurant, yeah, energy from Ike's Cafe on the way to the Kumasi Mall for drop-off, then hotel drop-off, and then our guys get some rest, and then they'll be ready to pick us up in the morning to take us back to Accra, where the journey ends. So family, it's been a beautiful journey of a lifetime, and if you don't see me in this video, you'll see me in other videos, but I'm not here to be modeling from the videos, just here to share everything that we do on these journeys, so you can see what you're paying for, you see what you're getting, so you can make the proper decision. That's all I'm about, family. So everything is on our website at africafortheafricans.org. And family, from there, you know, you click on the tour that you're looking for, or you click on the Black Star Investment if you're interested in investing in our community. And then from there, family, you read the information, you send me emails, let's talk on the phone, let's connect, let's be clear on everything, and compare what, you know, we went through, and, you know, and make the, you know, and make the proper decision on what journey or investment works for you. And as you see my brother right here, making sure that we get good documentation of photos, as our goal is always to give you videos and photos of every single tour that we have done, and we've done that from 2006 all the way to now, including the different countries like Ethiopia, Brazil, Tanzania, Togo, Benin, South Africa. And if I didn't mention Ethiopia again, because it is so nice, one of my best journeys ever, a very historical and cultural journey. So family, that's what we do here on the journey of a lifetime. Yeah. We connect us to us and do this together with us. Hello, my sister. Yes, yes. They even have some garden going on in here. And yesterday he was packed, so I'm gonna just give you a feel of what's in this section. Like I said, social gatherings and presentations, all those things are here at Ike's Cafe and Grill. And family, I want to say our first time here was November 2017. That was the Ghana, Togo, and Benin journey, which is my second Ghana, Togo, and Benin journey. So I will never forget this coming here and us just having lunch, and that was just perfect. I was invited by our good sister, Nana Ya Santiwa, which I've met and known from Atlanta, and now she has moved here, and this wonderful family at Ike's Cafe is from Ghana, but built their empire there in the Atlanta, Georgia area, and expanded from restaurants and stores to now this unique, incredible restaurant. I've never seen anything like this in my entire life. This place is huge, bigger than you can imagine. And once we finish at the top up here, family, we're gonna be able to get people to lodge here, and it's gonna be a true resort. Got the ice cream shop there, got the fish ready for grilling. Popcorn machine, receptionist. And the beautiful arts. When you walk in, you see the beautiful craft, the beautiful plants. This, Kumasi is also the garden city. This beautiful greenery and big on garden. And this is where we just viewed earlier. So as soon as you come in, it's to your right. So that's what we're talking about, family. Black economics and black investment. Right? And that's what we do, family. We have to invest back into our continent. Whatever we feel that's not here, we make it happen. We pull our resources together. And if we, now here some of us talk about we built America. If we built America, we could build anything else. I'm not here to debate with that that notion. I mean, it's all good. I respect, the struggle and the fight of our ancestors. And respect us overcoming whatever we have to overcome in America and other parts of the African diaspora, but the focus of the future has to be about African nation building. Yeah? And not all of us gonna return to the continent, so wherever we are, we must enterprise so we can do business and keep on connecting with the continent. And this is a part of it here, family. It's a part of it here, family. Another elevated view. Mr. Bomani Dakari, what's up with you, man?